Hello friends, now we will discuss about the equivalence of NFA with DFA. Right, already we discussed what is the major difference between DFA and NFA. NFA is having only one transition for each and every input symbol from each and every state, but in NFA we are having more than one transitions for each and every input symbol, more than one or zero transitions from each and every state. That is the major difference between NFA and DFA. And how we are converting the NFAs into DFA? Likewise, if you are having an NFA, means there must be an equivalent DFA, right? If you are having an NFA for some particular string or for a particular language, then there will be an equivalent DFA for that same language, right? If and the number of states in NFA is equal to number of states in NFA is equal to n. If the number of states in NFA is equal to n, then the number of states in DFA is equal to 2 power n. Number of states in DFA is equal to 2 power n. If the number of states in an NFA is equal to 3, then the DFA is having some 2 power 3 states, that is equal to 8. The maximum number of states possible for constructing a DFA is equal to 8. Among the 8 states, the states reachable from the start state, right, based on the given problem or given NFA, the states reachable from the start states are only considered for constructing the DFA. Considered for, what are the states considered for constructing the DFA, means the states reachable from the start state are only considered for constructing the NFA. Number of states may be up to 2 power n. If the number of states in NFA is equal to n, then how many states are possible for constructing a DFA is equal to 2 power n. And there are different techniques for converting NFA into DFA. One of the method is called as the subset construction. The first method is called as the subset construction. By using subset construction, the NFAs are converted into equivalent DFAs. Right? If you are example, if you are having three states like P, Q and R. If you are having three states in the NFA are P, Q and R. And what are the possible states for DFA by using subset construction, means that is equal to first one is if you are having three states in the NFA as P, Q and R, then what are the states possible for constructing a DFA, means that is first one is pi, empty state, and next one is P alone, next one is Q alone, next one is R, P, Q, R alone, next combinations, that is P, comma Q, and next is P, comma R, and next one is Q, comma R, and last one is the combination of all the three states, that is P, Q and R. These are the possible set of states for constructing the DFA. From this, how we are constructing the DFA, means first we have to extend from the start state. Here P will be considered as the start state. If P will be considered as the start state, means first we have to extend the start state. Extend the start state for the input symbol 0. Next, extend the start state for the input symbol 1. First we have to extend the start state for the input symbol 0, and next we have to extend the same start state for the input symbol 1. If you are having some state, the set of states, right, obtained by using this extensions or the states of the DFA. The set of states obtained by using this extended transitions of the start states belongs to the states of the DFA, right? Example, if you are having the states as a P, R. If you are having the state as P, R. P, R is a state of a DFA. P, R is a state of a DFA. So next we have to extend the state P, R for the input symbol 0 and P, R for the input symbol 1. Like this we have to extend till all the states will be an existing state, right? We have to extend all the states obtained by using this extension, right? All the states obtained by using this extension from the start state, and all the states extended by using this transitions will be included for the construction of the DFA. While constructing the DFA, if a state is having a final state, example, if Q will be considered as a final state, if this will be considered as a final state, means a state which comprises of Q. Right, a state which comprises of Q means what are the state comprises of Q? P, Q is having Q, PQR is having Q, right, and QR is also having Q. So this three states will also be called as the final states of the DFA. Like this, we have to construct a DFA from NFA. Number of states in NFA is equal to n, then possible number of states for DFA is equal to 2 power n. And what is the method here we are using? Subset construction. These are the subsets formed using these three states. And what are the states possible means among the states, the states reachable from the start state are only considered for using the construction of the DFA. Right? Thank you.